Joseph Rafiki Biden. There's no doubt that he's got a tough job ahead of him. But in his inauguration speech last week, Biden made clear what his top priority is.
To overcome these challenges, to restore the soul and secure the future of America, requires so much more than words. It requires the most elusive of all things in a democracy. Unity.
But look, I get it. America has been divided over the last 4 years. Technically 12 if you include Obama's years. Actually, it was pretty divided under Bush. And Clinton. Oof, yeah, that was bad. Oh, you also had the 60s and the Civil War. I mean, the Civil War. Oh, man, you know what also wasn't great? The whole thing with the Pilgrims and the Indians either. All right, so America's been divided for like 2,000 years now. The point is unity. So I can see why unity would be very appealing for people right now. But for unity to work, you have to agree on what unity is. And in Washington right now, they're not even united on that.
U.S. Senator John Cornyn from Texas, his response to the inclusion of transgender people in the military was to tweet, "Another unifying move by the new administration?"
Democrats claim to want to unify the country, but impeaching a former president, a private citizen, is the antithesis of unity.
Joe Biden, you talk about unifying the country. Pursuing impeachment after he leaves the office will further divide the country.
It's hard to unify when you're impeaching a president who's already left office.
Joe Biden vowed that his top priority was, quote, unity. Does anyone at this point still believe him? Anybody? Raise your hand at home.
Raise your hand at home? Dude, only one of your viewers is dumb enough to think that you can see him through the TV. Because this is ridiculous, right? Apparently Republicans think that unity means the Democrats have to act like Republicans. That's not what unity is. Unity does not mean agreement. It doesn't mean doing whatever the other side wants. Unity means the state of being united. And united means unified. And unified means to be in for the same thing. And thing, same thing means, I'll tell you this much. Unity doesn't mean you just do what the losers want, all right? It definitely doesn't mean that you can't hold Trump accountable for what he did. That wouldn't fly in court. You are accused of manslaughter. How do you plead?
I plead unity, Your Honor.
Man, get your ass to jail. And it's one thing to try to find unity with people who disagree with you on policies, but how do you find unity with people who don't even recognize your legitimacy?
A clear majority of House Republicans who are now kind of braying about unity voted to overturn the election and in effect make Trump president for 4 more years over the will of the voters.
This election was not stolen. Do you accept that fact?
Well, what I would say is that the debate over whether or not there was fraud should occur. We never had any presentation in court where we actually looked at the evidence.
Republican Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene, a QAnon supporter, she has repeatedly indicated support for executing prominent Democratic politicians. 2019, she liked a comment that said, quote, "A bullet to the head would be quicker to remove House Speaker Nancy Pelosi." In 2018, she said, quote, "The stage is being set," after someone asked whether they could hang President Obama and Hillary Clinton.
Holy shit. This Marjorie Taylor Greene lady wanted to shoot Pelosi and hang Obama and Hillary? This woman is something else. It's like a normal Karen fell into a vat of chemicals and then became a Batman villain. I mean, how can you achieve unity with someone who's literally wanting you dead? There's a reason why Planet Earth never ends with a bill being signed. And suddenly the cheetah lunges at the young gazelle, eager to reach a bipartisan agreement. Seriously, people, forget the country for a minute, right? That's their coworker. Imagine going into work every day knowing one of your coworkers wants to kill you. A coworker stole my yogurt one time and I still hold it against him. I was hungry for 20 minutes that day, Kevin. You're a monster! Look, Considering where the Republican Party is right now, I don't know if the two sides can really come together, but it would be fun watching them try to talk their issues out.
Today, we're here to work on unity. Now, this is a safe space to share your feelings and hopefully find some common ground. Democrats, let's start with you. What does unity mean to you?
We want unity. You know, it's about coming together and, you know, respecting each other.
Wrong.
Ah, Republicans, you had a very strong reaction to that. What does unity mean to you?
Unity is bringing everyone in the country together to do exactly what we want all the time. And if you have a problem with that, we'll storm your office. That's what unity is.
Very good sharing. I love how honest you're being.
Yep.
Democrats, is that something you think you might be open to?
No. He just said he wants to storm my office.
Or put you in prison.
What?
Ah, options. Very good. Very good.
You know what? I feel we should have a bigger say. We won the election.
You stole the election.
Now, remember, compromise, okay? So how about Democrats won the election by stealing it?
Yeah, that's fair.
No, it's not. Look, we just want the Republicans to come to the table in good faith and find areas we can agree on so we can pass meaningful laws.
Okay, let's explore this. Republicans, when Democrats just said that, what is it that you hear?
I heard that they want mandatory Sharia socialism and to put RuPaul in the $50 bill. That's what she said.
That's not what I said at all. Although I am open to the RuPaul thing, kind of jazz up the money, but listen. If they really wanted unity, how do they explain the Capitol riots?
Well, that could have been a real moment for unity, but there wasn't a single Democrat in that mob because they're all talk with no insurrection.
See, this is what he does. It's always my fault.
Well, it is always your fault. It's your fault every single time. You're always making it your fault.
Okay,
you're walking around like it's not my fault. It's not my fault.
You can stop. You can stop, both of you, stop. Especially the Democrats. Look, we're almost out of time. So what I'd like to do is just take a step back and look at all the progress we've made.
Excuse me? Progress?
There has been no progress.
See? You finally agreed on something. You're both united behind the fact that you can never unite. Unity achieved. Republicans, you're cured. Democrats, let's pick this up again next week. We have a lot to work through.
Cool, because I got to run. I'm parked in a handicapped spot. So thanks.
Of course you did. Of course you did.